we'll just get started. If you're listening to this recording later, my name is Gabby. You all know me by now, I think. Welcome to any new members of our virtual studio. We'll start our 60-minute vinyasa practice lying down on your backs. I have a block underneath my head. You could use a little pillow or nothing at all. Sometimes it's nice to support the head while we're lying down. Today we'll have the soles of the feet together, the knees wide. And place your hands somewhere comfortable, maybe somewhere on your body or by your sides. Somewhere you feel the most relaxed. So even if your head is directly on the mat and you don't have a block, give your chin a slight tuck to lengthen the back of your neck. Notice how the back of your neck is connected all the way to your tailbone. Maybe even feeling how it's connected to the heels. Letting the knees drop, letting the shoulders open up. And coming into a deeper breath. So we say this at the beginning of every practice. It really makes a difference. It's kind of what the whole practice is about, is linking our breath to our body or our mind to our body or slowing our thoughts, however you want to think about it. Kind of the easiest route is to listen to the sound of your breath. So with your lips sealed, take the tongue just on the roof of your mouth. It adds a constriction to your throat, and you can breathe more intentionally by listening to that hoarse sound in your throat. You can place your hands, one on your heart, one on your belly, and without thinking about it, notice which one rises and which one falls first. So without thinking one is right or wrong, as you're breathing, as you're widening these spaces underneath your hands and heavying your hands into these spaces, just switch up whichever one you noticed first. So for some people it's the chest, for some people it's the belly, kind of tricking the brain. And let's meet on an inhale, fill up the chest, fill up the ribs, all the way to the belly button. Take a pause, keep going, fill up the belly and the hips and the knees. Hi. Just doing some breathing. Exhale the belly and the chest and the ribs. Two more super dynamic breaths. Fill up the face and the limbs. And exhale. Softening your jaw and your face as you go. Breathe in. And breathe out. You can remove the block if you had one from behind your head. You can keep it handy wherever you need it and lie back down with your head down on the mat. Really slide back so there's like a bony part of your head on the mat. We are going to bend the knees, bend the knees, bend the knees. Grab the tops of the kneecaps, but hold the tops of the kneecaps so that there's weight in your hands and your arms go straight. And widen the knees if you can by opening up the arms. Don't let the knees do it. Let your hands do the action. Breathe there and give your tailbone a little tuck. Get more flat to the mat and breathe into those open hips. And bend the elbows to pull the knees in closer to you. So again, noticing if your knees are doing it or if your hands are doing it, try to get the knees to do it. Straight arms, making really slow circles. Knees are moving outwards. And one more big circle. So kind of a little arm workout by bending the elbows, pulling the arms forward, and bending the knees again. And when both knees are in, hold on to your right shin, lengthen your left leg, wind relieving pose. I'm a little bit far. Take a breath in, even out your hips by lengthening the right side. Breath out, a big squeeze, still with that arm strength. Keep that chin slightly tucked and both ribs pressing down. Flex like crazy your left foot, a nice chance to wake up the toes. Make space between your toes of your left foot and inner rotate your left thigh. Breath in, squeeze, breath out. So keep your torso the same, super flat to the ground. Left leg the same, lengthen the right leg, hold behind the hamstring and resist the right leg forward. So we have the support of your arms again. Yeah. Make big circles with the ankle, pulling the toes in towards the knee, out to the side, up to the ceiling and back. Noticing that pull behind the calf when you flex the foot and just go the other way, a couple of circles. Really waking up the feet in the winter is nice. We have our heavy boots on and the ground is really uneven. All right, from here, let's let go of the legs. See if we can keep it up pretty high. Take the arms by your sides and lift your other leg up to match two straight-ish legs. Let's move the legs away from the center line. Move them on a diagonal. Give your butt a little scoop up. So it feels like the tailbone is not facing straight forward. It's going up towards the ceiling. You might feel some action in your low belly. That's what we want. Let's take the hands behind the head to wake up our abs. Take a big breath in. Press the ribs down to lift your head and your shoulders. Any amount, it could really be a small hover. And notice if your legs, like mine, went back to straight, get them back to the diagonal. You can hold this, or you can take a breath in, and you can take the right toes halfway down. Breath out. Bring the right leg back up. Only doing the right leg, exhale, reach that leg back down. Inhale, comes back up. Both legs are on a diagonal, exhale, lower it down. Inhale, come back up, little challenge, reach your arms over your head, same thing, three times, breath in, breath out, long right leg. Good, inhale, and exhale, inhale. And exhale, first hands behind the head, legs straight up, head comes down, knees come in. Hold onto your kneecaps in the same way as we started and let those knees relax into the hands. You are holding onto the knees, the whole weight of your legs. Take a breath into the big wide open belly and an exhale. From here, we're making different circles with the hips. The knees go in towards each other. Open as much as they can. Let the legs fall and pull the weight forward a little bit. So don't be afraid of the movement of the rest of the body. Lead your circles with the strength of your arms. Pulling yourself forward and in and around. The sky was such a natural. Nice. This time, left leg stays close, right leg extends long. Firm up, the left hip pushes down, right toes flex, separate your right toes. Maybe they're different from your left toes. Push both shoulder blades down. Take the inhale, relax your left foot and squeeze. So I know this hip is more sensitive. It wants to hike up towards my shoulder. I pull it down away from my shoulder and find both sides of my ribs firmly in the mat just to help that stretch. Stretching from my heel to the top of my head on the right side. Hold behind your hamstring and left leg extends, but let the weight pull forward. So your arms are in a sling, let them hold your leg. And we point the toes, make a circle with your ankle, like a really deliberate circle, taking all the time in the world, going one way and the the other way. Maybe you feel something a little stuck, you want to stay a little longer. It's always your practice. This, we'll let go of the leg, see what happens. Lift the other leg to match. Start with your hands just by your sides to get a little tuck of your tailbone. Not a big movement at all. It's like you're making your bum a little lighter. We'll take those legs on a diagonal. We'll take the hands behind the head and a big breath in. Scoop the belly in to come up, breath out. Nice, take an inhale. Left leg comes halfway down. Challenge is to not move the right leg. And we lift it back up. Inhale, it comes down. Exhale up. Keep curling in. Exhale down and up. Challenge, arms straight behind your head. Push the ribs. Lower just the left leg. We only have two more. Abs will be super awake for our practice. And up. Last one. And up. This time bend both knees. Give them a squeeze straight up and in. Cross your ankles. Roll back. Roll forward. Take your time. We'll meet in a downward facing dog. So crossing through. Find your hands on the mat. Firm them up and step back. And you know the drill. Pushing your hips up. And as always, you can bend one knee. You can shake out your hips. Nice. Pulling the heels to the ground, but lifting the sitting bones up towards the ceiling. Power in the legs from pressing down into the toes. Let's stay here and hang your head and widen those shoulder blades on the spine, pulling them down towards the ribs. Push the ground even more with your hands. Big breath in, even an Ujjayi breath like we started with, and out of the nose. And bend the knees a lot so that the hips lower towards the ground. Hold this for a second and push like crazy. So it's still a downward facing dog in your upper body, but you have bent knees and you're pushing the hips back as much as you can. You might start to tingle in the arms and definitely the quads. Take a breath in. Push yourself forward to a plank pose. Stack your shoulders over your wrists. Push the ground so you have straight arms, spin, spiral in the elbows, and push back through the heels. Lengthen the chest forward. Take your knees down to the ground, just the knees. Untuck your toes. Lower the hips by squeezing through the glutes. Widen the collarbones and hold this. Take a breath in. Bend the elbows, try halfway down, breath out. Take an inhale here, all the way down to the mat, exhale. Point your toes, press the tops of your feet, try even that pinky toe so the kneecaps come off of the ground. Head lifts 1 inch, hands lift 1 inch in this position. Squeeze the back body like crazy and don't lose the squeeze of the feet. Reach your arms out to the sides, keeping those elbows pretty high. Make little fists with your palms. So tucking the fingers in and wrapping the thumbs around. Lift from the elbows and go for a little fist bump behind your back. Waking up the shoulders. Interlace your fingers. Pull the hands back, straighten the arms. Lift the chest as high as you can go with your straight arms. Stay and pulse down with the hips. Take an inhale, stay on the exhale. Nice, one more breath in. All the way down to the mat, release the hands, take the hands down. Breath in, baby cobra, you still have strong legs, use more strength in your arms. Child's pose, push yourself back. Tuck the chin and have a seat down onto your heels. Make our hands super active. Push the mat away with the hands. Space behind the body to fill up. pull yourself forward on the inhale. We're in a tabletop. Again, stacking the shoulders in line with the wrists. I do a few different variations of the plank today. So we'll start with tucking the toes under, really leading that chest forward and pulling the ribs in. Take a breath in, lift the knees off of the ground on the breath out. Hold it, inhale. Let's squeeze the thighs together on the exhale. So your knees are wide apart on the breath in. Exhale, squeeze your thighs in, breath out. One more, open up, inhale. Squeeze your thighs, exhale. We open up, inhale. Downward facing dog, up and back. You can walk your hands forward if you need. You can sway the hips and drop your head. Nice. Bend the knees. Drop the hips back like you're lengthening your spine to the back of your mat. Or you can think of it like making a spring in your legs. You want strong legs pushing from the feet. Look forward. Inhale. Into a plank, just like before on the exhale. A little bit faster. Push the mat from the palms. Inhale. Knees come down. Untuck your toes. Exhale. Lengthen your spine. Lengthen. Open up the collarbones. Halfway down, bend the elbows, or for me, it's less than halfway. Belly in, breath in, all the way down to the mat, forehead comes down. Strong legs, hips press down, lift the hands in the same position off of the mat. Widen the arms out in a T shape. Turn the palms. So the palms face up towards the ceiling, going a little slower. Nice. This time we'll hover the toes off of the mat. Make little fists with your palms. Take a breath in. Keep the elbows up and bend your elbows like you're going to touch your knuckles behind your back. Do that. Drive the knuckles higher up the spine. Hold this. 3, 2, 1. Interlace your hands behind your back. Pull with the hands, lift with the toes. Pressing the pubic bone down, breath in, stay, breath out. One more, add a back bend as you reach all the way down, forehead down, hands close to the ribs. Strong feet press down, arms squeeze in towards the torso. Facing dog or baby cobra or some in between. And child's pose, bending the knees, press the palms, sit back down onto your heels. Nice. Pull forward and through a tabletop. So I'll show you this way in case you didn't catch it, but probably did. In your tabletop, we'll tuck the toes under. Really set it up so that the abdomen is working. We'll lift the knees off of the ground. We'll take a breath in and we'll squeeze the thighs together. So your thighs are going into touch on the breath out. Inhale, we separate the knees. Exhale, we squeeze the thighs. Inhale, separate. Nice, and exhale, squeeze. And open up, and we'll meet back in our downward facing dog. So up and back with the hips. Yes, you can stay with this variation of bending the knees and going to plank. We're gonna find a Surya A. So lifting the heels off of the ground. Look forward, take your breath in. Maybe walk or hop if you're ready, your feet to the front of the mat. Toes can touch or be slightly close. Come up halfway, touch your shins, lift the chest, kind of pushing the tailbone back away from the collarbones. Breath in. Breath out, refold, soften the knees, and drape your upper body over your lower body. Today, stay here for a breath cycle, clearing your mind. Next, inhale, it starts from the push of the feet. Lift yourself up, reach your arms over your head. super tall spine, hands to your heart center. Eyes can be open or closed. Picture the whole length of your spine. Inhale, lift your ribs up to your shoulder tips. Exhale, keep them there, but relax the shoulders down. Arms circle up overhead like you're going to touch the walls, then touch the ceiling. Soften your knees, forward fold, touch the ground with your fingertips. Halfway up, breathe in. Plank and lower in one breath. Step, step, or hop, chaturanga, or to the mat. Point your toes, upward facing dog, thighs lift, open up the chest. Downward facing dog, hips up and back, relax the heels. One more, full variation. You can modify or not. Lift the heels, look forward. Bend the knees, go forward. Halfway lift, and all the way full. Right away, coming up, circle the arms over your head. Hands to your heart center, and we'll pause. Feel the palms press. Feel the eyes soften. Arms reach up, maybe you look up, dive down. We can take the arms wide as you dive down, almost like a swan dive. Halfway lift, take an inhale. If you're hopping back, we hop back into bent elbows, bend the knees, look forward, and hop back. You land in your chaturanga. Upward facing dog, untuck your toes and downward facing dog, up and back we go. Nice, a little different. Lift your heels, look forward, breathe in. Soften your knees, step, step, or hop to the front. Halfway up, breath in, and fold, breathe up. Rise up, circle your arms over your head. Keep them up there, grab onto your left wrist. Strengthen around the hips, so squeeze all those muscles around the hips from the big toe leading to the inner thighs. Tailbone drops down and hips press forward. Keep like a belt around your hips, side bend over to the right side. So you're pulling your bicep towards your ear, opening up the ribs. Contracting the right side of the body for your stretch. Little challenge to stay here longer, softening the knees and breathing, pulling. Arms come back up. Bend your knees, have a seat in an Utkatasana pose. Hips go straight back. Fingertips separate, circle your biceps in and pull your ribs back. Lean back. From here, we'll bring the left knee in towards the chest, straighten the right leg. Take a big step back with your left foot. We're in a warrior one. The left heel turns out, right knee stays bent. Roll the right hip back. Pull the ribs in, same thing, hold on to your left wrist, take an inhale. Side bend over to the right, extending all the way from the heel now to the wrist. Inhale brings you back up. Exhale, fold so your hands are framing your front foot. Pull the weight forward. Lift into a three-legged dog. We tuck the back toes. Right leg swings up. Stay. Inner rotate your right thigh. Even out your hips. Equal weight in your hands. Breathe in. Knee to your nose. Breathe out. So more like a plank shape. Right leg swings back and up, breath in. Same thing, right knee draws in, breath up. This time, stay, and it's a three-legged plank. Just send the right leg back. Don't lift the hips up. Right knee comes in. Three-legged dog, lift the right leg all the way up. Bend the knee and open the hip. Like a side bend on your other side, you can lighten up the right hand and look underneath your right armpit. Nice, square your hips, land your right foot down to the mat. Pull forward into a plank. Here you can bend the knees and spring the legs. So I've been really into this variation to come forward into my plank pose. Keeps the legs strong. Exhale, lower down with the knees, without the knees. Inhale, back bend, upward facing dog. And exhale, downward facing. Heels lift, look forward. Step, hop, travel to the front. Halfway lift, and we fold. Rise up, reach the arms. This time we hold on to the right wrist. Stay and get your base strong. Everything tunes into the center line of the body. Starting from those big toes, anchor yourself down. Side bend to the left, stretch open the right side. Soften the neck, soften the eyes. Nice, coming back up to center. Keep the arms over your head or not. Have a seat into your Utkatasana pose. Same variation, maybe you go just lower with the tailbone, more bend of the knees, stronger in the heels. Then we straighten left leg, bring the right knee in, arms can stay over your head. Step back, land soft, right foot on the diagonal, left knee bends. Turn the right hip to face forward. Push back from the right kneecap. And same thing, holding onto your right wrist, take an inhale. Side bend to the left on your exhale. Nice, rise up. Fold, take your fingertips to frame your front foot. Lift into a three-legged dog, swing the left leg under and back. Inner rotate the thigh. Equal push in the palms, long arms, lower your right heel. Breath in, knee to your nose, round and pulled out. Left leg up and straight behind you, breathe in. Knee to your nose, breathe out. This time a little different. Stay more in a plank, send just the left leg behind you. And bring it back in towards your nose. Left leg reaches up and back, three-legged dog. Bend the knee and open up your hip, breathe out. Make it a side bend, look underneath your left armpit, and your left hand can be a little lighter. Nice. Back to a three-legged dog. Both feet to the ground, flow or skip it. We'll meet back here. I'm gonna hang out here in my downward facing dog. Nice, when you're ready, right leg lifts. Keep it inner rotated, push the left hip back, look forward and step forward, low lunge. Untuck your back toes. Press into the ball of your foot to squeeze the inner thighs and reach your arms over your head. Pull the navel in, extend the spine from the pubic bone. Big breath in. Cactus open your arms by pulling the elbows back like you're offering your palms up towards the ceiling. So The challenge is to stay here and still feel your feet pressing down. One more, we'll inhale. So re-extend your spine and exhale, bend the elbows. Pull the elbows back wherever you are. Flip the palms to face up and squeeze the shoulder blades. Nice, arms reach. Frame your front foot and bow. Tuck your back toes under, straighten both of your legs. Pyramid pose, let's really bow, kind of pick to counteract. So tuck the chin in towards the throat and let the upper body drape over the front leg. Still rolling the right hip back. So we'll extend halfway up, breath in, and fold like you're curling under, breathe out. Stay low to the ground, walk your hands forward. Standing splits, kick your left leg up and behind you. Really like a seesaw, as your chest goes lower, the leg goes higher. Let's stay and inner rotate that left thigh. Take a breath in. Bend the knee and open up the hip, breath out. We're going to look forward, lengthen the spine. Sneak this left knee through, bend both knees and see if we can land in a Navasana pose. So on your sitting bones, with your knees bent, squeeze the abs. Really simple, we'll reach the arms to one side. And we'll find our little twist, so over to the other side. Breath in, and breath out. Breath in, and breath out. Face forward, take your feet down to the mat. Take your hands behind you, that stretch the tops of the thighs like a reverse tabletop. Pull the knees forward, open the chest. Straighten out the arms to squeeze your glutes to come up. Try to keep your head lifted, looking straight up at the ceiling. Then we'll lower the seat back down to the ground. Hold on to the backs of your thighs or not. We're gonna rock forward and rock back. Really make sure you have a nice rounded spine. Hopefully meeting back in Utkatasana pose or something. Maybe you need your hands and that's okay. So we'll start our roll back, getting some momentum in the feet and using the arms to reach forward. Maybe you get a little lift of your seat until we come back into our Utkatasana pose and we'll meet in a forward pose. Halfway lift, breath in. Step your left foot back on the breath out. The right knee is bent. Left hand on a block or the ground. Open up the right side, twisted lunge. Circle in your left thigh and down the right hip. His right hand comes down to the ground. Three-legged dog, right leg up and back. Breath in. Take your knee to your nose, breathe out. Right leg up and back. Knee to your nose, breathe out. Take your right leg out to the side. So kind of on the left side of your mat, ball and triangle, left arm reaches over your head. Pivot so both feet are on the ground. The inside of your left foot, the outside of your right. Push your hips up and back bend if you can. From here, dropping the hips, so we're in a little bit of a seat. Yeah, so we kind of flipped over. Take the right foot on the inseam of your left thigh. Ground your hips. Take your left hand down, find your side bend, reaching the right arm up and over, pulling the right hip down and away. Okay, circle back. Joy pose, like our counter pose. Left hand pulls forward. Open up the hips and reach the left arm. Look down, take your left hand down. Little tricky, straight back into a downward, or three-legged dog, sorry. Lifting that right leg up. Bend the knee and open up your hip. Or wild thing, flip over on the toes on your left foot and reach your arm over your head, pushing the mat away with your left arm. And look down, right hand comes down, downward facing dog. Forward, plank pose, breathe in, knees down, all the way down, breathe out. Baby cobra on your inhale. Let's do a child's pose with wide knees on your exhale. Keep your right hand where it is and sweep the left arm underneath your right armpit. Rest your ear to the mat. Straighten your arms. Pull yourself first into a tabletop. Tuck your toes under, lift your knees, lift your hips, straighten your arms. Downward facing dog. Left leg reaches up and back. Step your left foot through, land in your lunge. Set it up so you have square hips. That's really what we want to keep in this pose. And push down to rise straight up. Rearranging as you need, pulling the tailbone down. So not so much like a tuck, it almost feels like you're pulling the hips forward and the ribs back. Breath in to get an inch taller. Breath out, bend your elbows, pull the hands back. Like your hands are heavier than your elbows, really nice. Still, we're stable in our pelvis. And hold it, that's kind of the hard part. Arms reach up, get some movement back. And bend the elbows, pull back. You're making your back body a little smaller, your front body way bigger. We'll reach the arms up, take a breath in. Take your hands down to the mat. Find a pyramid pose with a fold. Walk your back foot in. Tuck the chin and round the upper spine as you push your sit bones up towards the ceiling. Halfway lift, big breath in. All the way fold, tuck the chin and round. Walk your hands forward, standing splits, lift the right leg up as you spin it in, bow to your shin, and bend the knee, open up your hip, get even higher with your knee. Nice, breath in. We're sneaking that leg through. As you extend your spine, maybe both feet to the ground, seat to the ground, land in your Navasana pose if you can with straighter legs. Reach the arms forward, take a breath in. Halfway down, breath out. Lower your torso and your legs. Inhale, we come up. Exhale, we lower down. Inhale, up. Exhale, we lower. Stay, hover. Bend your knees, hands behind you. Stretch out the abdomen, pull your hips up, reverse tabletop. Same variation, just pulling the chest up towards the ceiling. So then we go, we have another chance. The seat comes back down to the ground. Rolling yourself into a small, tiny ball, like the forehead's towards the knees. Roll back and forth. Catch a little lift maybe into an Utkatasana pose. Let's say we all did it. We meet in a forward fold. Extra breath cycle, inhale and exhale. Halfway up, breath in. Step your right foot back, twisting lunge. Right hand stays back, left arm reaches like a lever to pull the chest up. Stacking the shoulders, keep the hips low. Nice, left hand comes down to the ground. Three-legged dog with your left leg up and back. Bring that knee straight in towards the nose. Pushing into the palms, left leg up and back. One more time, pull that knee in and pause. Kick it out to the right side. Turn your feet, maybe turn your chest and your arms fall in triangle. And let's have a seat lower, just the hips. You have your wide open, yeah, stance. Left leg tucks into the right thigh. Right hand lowers, left arm. Like the side bends we've been doing, contract your right side to open up the left side. Left hand comes down, joy pose. Reach your right arm up, pull your hips up. Extra little back bend. And we'll look down, flip your feet, three-legged dog, left leg reaches up, breath in, bend the knee, maybe stay here, maybe stay with the chest turning, or wild thing, tap the tippy toes, right leg goes long and the left arm reaches, pushing with the right arm and rolling that shoulder back. Nice, turning to face down, just a downward facing dog. Come forward in through a plank, all the way down to the mat. Up dog or baby cobra. Into our child's pose, bend the knees. Keep the hands pressing and the right arm underneath the left. For threading the needle arms, rest your right ear on your shoulder or the mat. Down, tuck the toes under, lift the knees, downward facing dog, heels high, look forward, breathe in, try a hop, bend the knees, load up your spring, look where you're going, and hop the feet so they land through, halfway up, breath in, lower all the way, breath out, rise up, reach your arms over your head. Take your hands to your hips, find tree pose, right foot on the inseam of your left thigh, just like our side bend, but push that right hip back and the right knee open to the side. Arms come over your head. If you can balance, grab onto the left wrist. Little side bend towards the right side. You're pushing your right foot into your right thigh, kind of to counterbalance this side bend. It's okay if you're sleeping with me. Coming back up to center. Bring the right knee in, hold on to the outside of your knee and twist. Right hand behind you, push from the left leg. Nice. Hands come back up, feet come down. Utkatasana pose, bend both of your knees. Breath in, breath out. Nice, then warrior one, lift the left knee in, or sorry, not warrior one, just lift your left knee in. Topple your tree. So we'll get there a little slower. Arms come back. Kick your left leg back. Turn the left toes down. Right foot is pressing. You can soften your knee as much as you need. Reach the arms. Pull the belly in and extend from the sternum. Bend the right knee more. Step the left foot down. Now it's our warrior one. Here we go. Arms reach up. Pull the tailbone down. Bend those elbows. Lift the palms up towards the ceiling. We're opening up, but keep the bend in the right knee. Holding it and squeezing those shoulder blades together. Stay or interlace your hands behind your back. They're almost there. Pull the hands down towards the thigh. Bow forward by drawing the right hip back, making room and looking down at the ground. You can even bow your head. Fingertips to the ground. Step your right foot back. We're in a plank pose. Hold your plank. Right forearm comes down to the ground. Left forearm comes down to the ground. Pull the chest forward. Pull the heels back. Pressing from the wrists all the way to the elbows. Find a forearm child's pose. So drag your forearms down to the mat and have a seat on your heels and drop your forehead down. Nice. From here, we're going to tuck the toes under in your forearm plank, or sorry, forearm child's pose. Pull the knees a little bit closer together. Walk your forearms a little bit closer and press the forearms down. You have your spring in your legs here. We're going to move straight into a forearm plank. Take a breath, or sorry, straight into a plank. Take a breath in. Feel your hands in the mat. Breath out. Push into your hands and your feet. You're in a plank pose. Nice. And up and back, downward facing dog. Lift your heels high, breathe in. Bend your knees, find that spring again in the legs. Look forward, inhale. Hop forward by dragging your hands back in your feet. Good. Halfway up, breath in. And fold, breathe out. Rise up, reach your arms, grow tall. Take your hands to your hips. Pose left foot on the inside of the calf or fits comfortably on the inside of your thigh. Move the left knee open, the tailbone down. You can stay here or arms reach. Hold on to your right wrist. Push your left foot more actively into your thigh. Side bend to the left side. So counterbalance with the push of your ribs. Back towards center. Pull the left knee in, hold on to the outside of your knee, stretch your left arm behind you, pushing from the right leg, twisting. We let it go, both knees bend. Utkatasana, you can touch the ground, you can reach your arms up. Last one, breathe in, lower your hips, breathe out. And we come up with the right knee in towards the chest, toppling tree, arms move back, inner thigh lift. Make your right leg as strong as your left leg. Forward, soften the left knee, land with the right foot like you wouldn't make a sound. Right foot is on a diagonal. Find your balance, turn your hips forward, warrior one, straight up with your arms. So without underestimating our back leg, it's super strong. Bend the elbows, pull the elbows forward and the hands back. over and reach for your hands behind your back. Keep this opening for a breath. Pull the hands down. Bow forward like you're going past your knee. Keep pushing into your back foot and rolling the left hip back. Maybe bowing your head, straightening the arms and pulling them up. Fingertips to the mat. Let's meet back in our plank pose. Step your left foot back. You have both hands here. Okay, so breath in, breath out. We bend both knees and we bend both elbows at the same time. And we try to land elbows and knees at the same time in like our little forearm child's pose. Good. Coming back up just one more time. Tuck your toes. Look forward. Your forearms are already in the right place. Take a breath in. Into a plank on the breath out. Inhale. And back down. Forearms down. Knees bend. This time make it a real child's pose. Untuck your toes. And let the arms go back. Rolling the shoulders. Letting the forehead find the mat. Eventually, we'll roll ourselves up. You can crawl forward if you're off the mat like I am, into a hero's pose with either knees together and the feet on the outsides of your hips, or toes touch and the knees go wide. A block is nice for support, so we can lay here and unwind a little bit. So I'll do more the traditional one with the inner thigh squeezing in, feet on the outside. I lift and tuck, lower yourself down onto a prop or just on the mat. You can cactus open your arms. We're mimicking the shape we've been doing, but it's really passive, so those arms are just letting go. Stretch your arms over your head and place the backs of the wrists on the ground, softening the elbows, getting a long line in the front of the body. And really, you have the option to end your practice here if you're really in a comfortable spot. My hands to come up, tuck the chin, press yourself up at the same time, so less and less wiggling side to side if you can. Just come onto your knees and tuck your feet under for really a traditional forward fold, so the end of our practice. I'm going to do a wide version. You have always the option of legs together, always the option of a block underneath your hips. I might just do it for fun. Coming to the front edges of your sitting bones. So really not a rounded spine. It's almost like an arched spine. Flex your feet and spread those toes. Really nice active legs for our forward folds. Reach the arms up. Spin the biceps in. Like you are floating off of the block or the mat. You want this length in your spine and strength. Take an inhale. Bow and hinge forward with your long arms for as long as you can reach. Then let the arms kind of help you out and bow the head and fold and stay. Legs are active, but spine becomes less and less. eventually letting go even of the action in your feet.
Any more action in your brain?
Come up, we slowly roll ourselves up. And drag your knees in. Remove any props or get any props that you like for your Shavasana, and that's where we'll end. Really carefully placing yourself down on the mat. You can even do a nice legs up the wall. Make yourself comfortable. Scan your body, your mind starts to wander, noticing the feeling from your toes all the way up the legs. From the hands all the way up the arms. All the way up towards the ribs.